So firstly, I'm very happy that I'm participating in a program of Telangana Chambers of Commerce, because I'm from your sister state. I'm an MP from Andhra Pradesh. I'm very proud to be representing Telugus in Parliament. Therefore, I'm very proud that I could now, along with my mother, I'm also helping my mother's sister. That's what Telangana is. So I think we'll definitely like to work together and make sure that, along with the rest of the country, even Telangana is properly taken care of in terms of new era that we are entering into. The first shock was obviously everything was closed down. So the industry's problem was the entire economic activity came to standstill. So obviously the resultant sufferers are state government, central government, and all local governments. But more importantly, the local private sector. This is what, because they have immensely suffered losses because there was no production. And at the same time, the fixed expenses had to be incurred. So it's a very twin challenge that they were facing. Revenue loss, at the same time, taking care of the expenses. So we have passed that phase, and now we are entering the second phase of partial reopening. So the economy will partially reopen. But that again is a very crucial stage, as Mr. Ranjan was saying, that we have to calibrate it properly so that entire supply chain will also be opened at the same time. Otherwise, you open one front door, but a back door is closed, it is not going to work. So I think we have to ensure that seamless activities can be carried out by those economic entities who have the backward and forward linkages, and both end, they should be allowed to function properly. So that is a phase we are entering into. Then comes the third phase. And that is why, at a time when we have to work out, how do you now kickstart the economy? And more importantly, how do you grow economy faster? And both are going to have an impact on the industry. In fact, it is also the industry can help in growing the economy faster, but industry would also need huge hand-holding support from the government, first to compensate the losses, and secondly to expand their businesses. So at both ends, government and industry partnership will be very, very crucial. Now talking about growth, there are some macroeconomic measures have to be taken. So that is what the government is working on, pushing in monetary policy, which has created huge liquidity. The interest rates globally have come to, if not negative, at least very close to zero. So money is available plenty globally. And money will always chase good assets, good paper. So we'll have to figure out how India could benefit from it. And also at the same time, ensure that does not add to inflation, because too much of capital flows should not add to that. So we'll have to work on a proper calibrated strategy to take advantage of India's monetary policy, but also global monetary policy, which is bringing in a lot of liquidity into the marketplace. The packages which have been given, like in US, is more than $3.25 trillion already, another $3 trillion maybe. So that could mean India's GDP, which is $2.8, $2.9 trillion. The US package itself is more than India's GDP. And then that is how you add the packages that have been given by the large economy, the G7 economies, including Japan or including European Union, Canada. It is absolutely several trillion dollars money is going to be poured into the marketplace and already poured into the marketplace. And in that scenario, we have an advantage. As Mr. Ranjan was saying, how do you position ourselves to take advantage of this? So this can be one way to look at it from a macro perspective. Second will be, how do you make sure that grassroots economic activity also starts in a very significant way? In fact, there were some visible trends even before this pandemic came that there was a disruption in the global supply chains. It was very clearly visible. Or if not visible, it was probably, it could be discernible. That is, possibly will happen. I had set up a group as a Commerce Industry Minister under chairmanship of Mr. Surjit Bhalla, who is now, at that time, he was a independent economist. Now he's working with International Monetary Fund Executive Director. In that group, the present External Affairs Minister, Dr. Jaishankar, was a member. So that time again, he was a private citizen, he was with the Tata. Adil Zainulbhai, one of the very distinguished strategic thinker and also head of McKinsey, was a member. CI, Chandrajit Banerjee was a member, former Commerce Secretary, Rajiv Kher was top class people. And I spent a lot of time. And we have prepared a complete roadmap as to how do you take advantage of possibly emerging scenarios in which global supply chains will be disrupted. How do you make entry on such openings that are offered? At the same time, what type of response we should put in place to get proactively engaged with these emerging trends? So we are already prepared. With that report, there has been a very substantial work which has been done on each sector as well. And those sectors, some of them are very relevant to Telangana. And that is something which I got it done. I spent huge amount of time with them. And that report was processed even before the election results were announced for 2019 Lok Sabha election. And it is already under work. The second part, and that is something, and I'll come to Telangana a little later. Second part would be, when we talk about boosting growth, one, as I said, is macro level intervention, which are very, very crucial, very important, which will be done by the monetary policies or the fiscal policy, which has to be done. Second part will be opening up of so many sectors which have so many restrictions. For example, the government, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has already taken a very important initiative, that is opening of agriculture market. So this will have a huge positive impact, because internal trade itself can boost economy significantly. And agriculture was actually constrained by so many factors. The farmers were not getting the money, exactly the money that they deserve to get if the market was open. And it was a paradox that on one hand, as a member of WTO, we have opened up our markets as well as we are asking for global markets to be opened. Whereas in India, our domestic markets were not free and were constrained by so many restrictions. So that is one part response which Mr. Dev talked about, Dr. Dev talked about, absolutely right. We have to make the reforms possible so that these hidden possibilities of growth will come in. The third part would be, as we take macro level, can we do something at a micro level? And therefore, Mr. Ranjan, I would like to suggest something which you can also look at it very closely. I had thought about it, and this is about almost 3 years ago, I started this project, again as a Commerce Industry Minister. That suppose if each district of India grows at 3% more than normal. Now even Telangana, the growth rate, how do you calculate Telangana's growth rate? Telangana's growth rate is the aggregate of whatever district growth rate happens. What is the economic happening in each of the district, if you aggregate it, that's the growth of the state. So how do you make sure that each of the district grows at 3% more than normal? And to do this, you have to have a baseline. Otherwise, you can always claim that it is growing at 5% more if you don't have a proper baseline. So I involved Indian Institute of Management and National Council for Applied Economic Research to do this work on how do you make sure that prepare a proper district-wise plans, find out what is today's GDP of that district. You call for GSDP normally in case of a state. I don't know how you calculate district. Probably, Dr. Dev, you'll have to think about some good nomenclature for it, as because we have to focus on the district-led growth, the bottoms-up approach. And to do this, I chose 6 districts. On the south, in fact, Visakhapatnam, very close to part of Telangana, used to be part of their one state for until recently, Telangana in there. In north, it is Varanasi in UP. In east, it is Muzaffarpur in Bihar. And in west, it is Sindhudurg Ratnagiri in Konkan in Maharashtra.
YouTube channel,
and of course, Solan district in Himachal, just to find out how. This is the large district, large states also. How the hilly district will be fitting into this? You will be surprised that this report has revealed the huge potential for growth in each of the districts. Now, Mr. Ranjan, why I am telling you this?
YouTube, no?
Just imagine.
Please send
in one district
to YouTube.
You come to a conclusion that this district has a huge potential of a particular client. There are some construction workers from Telangana who used to go and work all over the country. Certainly, they are skilled. So they are not just going and manual workers. These are skilled workers. And today, we are realizing the importance of workers. When we are talking about labor, you know, labor is a problem. So this, without labor, you cannot function. So that realization has to come to the industry. So therefore, those skilled labor, based on the local resources available, like natural resources, if you can prepare a district plan, which can be then be scaled up, and just each district start growing at 3-4% more than what is growing today, whether in agriculture or services or industry, automatically that growth will come back into a different kind. So this is another approach, Dr. Dev, we have to think about, a bottoms-up approach while we do a macro-level intervention. And this is what I started doing before COVID. This had started way back 3 years ago. Reports are ready. I think I can also work with you as a friend of the state and can prepare something like this and help you to prepare it. And that is another way of doing it. Then comes, and what you mentioned about a potential, how India will benefit from it. I'll come to that. And that is why this report of high-level group under chairmanship of Sujit Bhalla has already prepared that map. Now, Telangana, traditionally, has done extremely well in some industries. In service sector, it's IT. Healthcare. Hyderabad has a great reputation of being one of the most dynamic cities of India. And Hyderabad is known globally for that dynamism, that entrepreneurship. So that came because of this, largely the service sector activity. But also in manufacturing, there's something which what Telangana has done is exceptional. And that is what is going to be the future. That's pharmaceutical. And I will tell you, in 1999, I used to be the Minister of Chemicals and Fertilizer, which included pharmaceuticals, 21 years ago. At that time, I had prepared a complete roadmap for both pharmaceuticals, chemicals, petrochemicals, all part of that, downstream activities, upstream activities. And at that time, I had told my friends from the industry, 21 years ago, mind you, or 22 years ago, I told them, why don't you go to Latin America to sell your products, in pharma products? Because I had actually talked to Brazil, to Argentina, and to many countries, ministers, and actually I prepared a groundwork. There was a lot of reluctance on part of the industry, and rightly so, because unknown territory, language barriers, huge cost in terms of travel, but I virtually almost forced them. Today, you ask the industry, Latin America is one of the big markets for the pharma industry. So what I'm trying to tell you is, in IT, there are going to be some challenges. Visa restrictions, the US, Europe being biggest market for Indian companies, they will have some problem. But there's other advantage. Why do you need visa to go to US now? Because you can do most of the work even without going to US, as we are talking to each other now. We never realized it before. We always knew it is possible through video conferencing, but we thought it is not possible unless we have a visit on site. Some activities, and of course, again, I'm qualifying my statement by saying not all activities can be done off site, but there are some possibilities. All activities cannot be done from off site, but some possibilities that you can manage it. The other possibility is that now IT industry, if they can figure out how to integrate into their IT business processes the new emerging technologies. Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, all of these big data. Just imagine today, the big data is the only way we can deal with corona. Why? Because we don't have vaccine. We don't have protocol. We don't have a formulation which can take care of them. We're still struggling to know whether it's a virus or whether it is something else. We don't know yet, conclusively. So how do people are dealing with this treatment? Using big data, finding out what would work, what is not working, what is the experience of Italy, what is the experience of China. On that, you're preparing models. And on that models, you're trying to work on it. So just imagine the huge potential for service sector in both Medicare, in healthcare, and also in IT generally. So if you can work out a strategy for service sector, it can be immensely beneficial in terms of future growth strategy. The second part of the manufacturing part, which I said pharmaceuticals, see, that is also part of a healthcare part of it, because of course healthcare is a much larger branch of the activity. But without medicine, of course, you cannot cure anybody. So pharmaceutical also will play a key role. Now again, in this pandemic, we have come to the conclusion that what is most important for us is the treatment part, that we need medicines. And India could supply to so many countries thanks to Prime Minister Modi, who played that very useful role. So now I'm saying, what are we good at? We are good in formulation. And some of the pharma industry that are doing, they are developing their own molecules. They don't drug delivery system. But we still have to rely on bulk drugs, which is coming from other countries. Can you now make Andhra Pradesh, I'm a member of parliament for Andhra Pradesh, Telangana. Can you make Telangana as a new hub for manufacturing of those requirement which goes into formulation. If you do that, I will tell you something. IDPL was a company which was specializing in making bulk drugs earlier, but that closed down. Dr. Reddy of Dr. Reddy Laboratories, who passed away, he was Anji Reddy, I think his first name was Anji Reddy, he passed away, used to work for IDPL. So inspiration for doing such a formulation company, which is now very well known worldwide, came from whom? From IDPL. So try to focus on such businesses where we already have a natural advantage. Can we work on downstream or upstream and try to make a completely value chain for this? Now, another point, and then only 2 points I'll make, and then I will leave it to you because I have to go. One, which Mr. Ranjan mentioned, and one Mr. Jasti mentioned. So let me first come to Mr. Ranjan's point. In medium term, we have tremendous opportunities because capital, first I told you, there is so much of money available in the world. Secondly, there is going to be re-looking at the existing supply chains. Both offer us opportunity to reposition ourselves and try to attract that foreign capital. We should come with manufacturing. One capital can come only as a private equity player or somebody who's making investment. But we should try to get that part of capital. We need, of course, the first part also, because we need that capital for our industry. But if you can get such industries which have the ability to manufacture substantially in India, why? Because that will create job opportunities for your membership, for the Telangana Chamber of Commerce, small industry. They will get huge opportunity because they will also become part of supply chain, the ecosystem. So we should try to attract that kind of investment, which is possible. And that Telangana must now position as a natural choice for those investors. So we'll have to strategize it, try to work on it. I'm willing to help you to also work on that part. So this is the other part. Now the point I was telling, if Mr. Jasti mentioned also, I'm just touching that point, about G20. See, G20 is 86% of the global GDP. All those countries put together 86% of the global GDP. So virtually, if it is the club or a grouping wherein most of the economic activities happen, only outside are 14% of the GDP, and of course, so many, more than 200 countries. So this is a very important grouping for India. Prime Minister Modi has been playing a very key and important role in this G20. He has talked to most of the leaders in G20 during the course of last few weeks. And now India, and also Sherpa for G7, G7 is 7 countries. But India was invited, Prime Minister Modi was invited for the last G7 summit, which happened in Biarritz in France. I was there. And that time, now Trump has invited Prime Minister Modi, but also thinking of expanding the grouping G7 and expanding it to maybe 11 or 10. And that's another opportunity for India. So we have a great level now in which we operate. But at the same time, we must use all that leverages, all those positions to benefit India and particularly the business of India. See, what is India's success story? What is India's growth story? It's an entrepreneurship-driven, private sector-led growth. So we want to bring that back, the private sector. We must bring the efficiency and entrepreneurship of these private companies who should benefit from the new growth that will happen in India. And also the growth will happen because of you. So we'll have to work as partners and make it happen. So I'm very happy that you have taken this lead. Only about 3 weeks back, I have spoken to all the chambers of commerce from Andhra Pradesh. And whatever feedback I got, I tried to work on each of those points. Some we could get immediate respite. Now, of course, we have reached another stage. Now we have to work on a completely different priority. The 50,000 crores, which are guaranteed by the government to be given to the housing industry, may be helping you to some extent. State government also, I know, it's also challenges, particularly on the fiscal level, because of loss of revenue. It's going to be very, very challenging for state also. But we can work together and ensure that chambers of commerce will also be lead warriors. I think if you talk about corona warriors, it is the chamber of warriors will be economic warriors.
Economic.
And I think that's why we have to recognize their important role and we can work together. And I think I will be very happy as you are one of you, as your honorary member, to work with you and to find out how best. So if you permit me, because there is another.
Sir, before, just there's one question that, you know, it's lingering with most of our participants and the industry, sir. Now, with regard to the 5 trillion economy, which Narendra Modi ji, Honorable Prime Minister, has vision, are we still on track, or you see any hiccups in the achievement by 2024?
I'll just tell you about this $5 trillion economy. And one thing I'll tell you. See, today's situation is quite challenging because we'll have, in fact, a negative output. Because obviously, because there's no economic activity. So the GDP will be in a very difficult terrain for this quarter for sure, but also maybe as a result of that first quarter of this current fiscal, it may even affect the year as a whole. But I'm very positive that we'll reach $5 trillion economy. Now, the time that will take might be a little longer, obviously. But I had prepared a plan as a Commerce Industry Minister, because when Prime Minister was talking about it, how does $5 trillion economy look like? And we had said, and actually that work was done very, very closely with industry. In fact, all industry players who are involved in economic activity, they're only involved. So not just general industry. For example, Mahindra. India is one of the largest manufacturing of India. 37% of the GDP in manufacturing comes from automobiles. And Pawan Goenka, who is head of, not Anand Mahindra, but Pawan Goenka, because hands-on head of their automobile division. So such people prepared it. So we said 20% of $5 trillion will come from manufacturing or other industry, not manufacturing alone, because industry is little more comprehensive than manufacturing. And which of that segment, what will constitute that $1 trillion, how much will come from cement, steel, what is the strategy for each of these already? Second, services. 60%, $3 trillion. 12 champion sectors were identified, for which 5,000 crore was allotted from the cabinet, already approved. And in fact, we have asked that time proposal from the state government to give proposal as to how we can leverage together to work on those 12 champion sectors, which will actually have a positive impact on the economy. And agriculture, $1 trillion, for which the first time we prepared an agriculture export policy. And I had announced it on the first day in the office and actually got it prepared and approved by the cabinet, for which, in fact, the Telangana government also has worked very closely with us, all state government. And we have prepared a district-wise plan, which district you can export. For example, haldi is very one of the big crop in Telangana. And in fact, my colleague, Kavita, who is to be member of parliament, used to always tell me about it. So I am telling such products can be exported. And India's export today is $26 billion from agriculture, can be extended to $100 billion. So we were trying to work on that. So the plan is not only a plan, but actual action-oriented action has been taken on each of these points. So this will happen. It might be delayed now because of this corona, but we'll be there. And now another aspect of growth will come from investment. And investment has to come, one, in infrastructure, but also we need private investment to grow, which has gone down considerably. And one of the reasons why it was going down was the capacity utilization of some of the industry had also gone down. Now, that leads to demand, as Professor Dev was saying. So we'll have to work on those issues together. But I am sure all these put together will add a lot of value to India's growth trajectory in the years to come. So thank you very much. We'll be in touch, and you can tell me anytime.